In this lecture, we will discuss about singleton design pattern. Singleton design pattern is used to create one and only one instance of a class and can be accessed by multiple clients. Okay, let's see the intent of singleton pattern. Ensure a class only has one instance and provide a global point of access to it. So we have two things. Ensure a class only has one instance and provide a global point of access to it. Okay, let's have a thought process for a problem and how we will come up with the solution. Okay, so we have resource manager for managing all the resources applicable for an application. We want to have only one instance of resource manager and multiple clients should be able to access this single instance. It is simple. We can have global variable for this instance, so the instance will be accessible from multiple clients. But again, it will not stop you from creating multiple instances. Okay, we will have another class creator which will have method to create the instance of resource manager. Creating the instance through method looks good, but how the problem of single instance creation and access to multiple clients will be solved? Moreover, it does not look good that another class is doing all this. Better we have resource manager itself managing single instance creation and global point of access to it. But resource manager will create multiple instances. Okay, we will make resource manager constructor private. So no one will be able to create the instance of resource manager. Good, but then how the instance of resource manager will be created? Okay, we will have public method. The method will have access to private constructor. So we will create instance inside this method. Good, but how this method will be accessed from outside when instance itself is not created? Okay, we will have this method as a static or class method. So this method will be accessible with the class itself and multiple clients will be able to access it. That's great. So by having a static method, global access is available for creation of instance. But again, how only one instance will be created? Okay, we will have some logic in a static method. So instance will be created only once and returned. Good, so it's fine for the first client to get the instance, but how multiple clients will be able to access it? Okay, we will have a static variable to keep the created instance. We will have logic in a static method to check whether the instance is created or not. So first time only instance will be created, but next time it will not create the instance. It will just return the static variable which keeps already created instance. So multiple clients will be able to access it. That's wonderful. So now it is ensured that class has only one instance and provides a global point of access to it. I have created UML diagram for this. So the class resource manager has a static method getInstance to get the instance of class. The class has a way to create instance only once and that is kept in static variable instance. For example, we can have the logic in getInstance method to check for the instance. If instance is already created, then return the same using static variable instance. Otherwise, it creates the instance and returns it to the client. There may be other ways, it is left for the implementation. Multiple clients can access this instance through static method getInstance. So we can see, resource manager provides the way to create one and only one instance of a class and can be accessed by multiple clients. Congratulations, you have gone through a thought process and have come up with a design solution for a problem. Okay, let's see the structure of singleton design pattern. It will give you good understanding of participant classes, relationship between classes, and how all of them work together. Okay, let's see the participant classes. We have only singleton class here. It has responsibility to create single instance and provides instance access to multiple clients. It has a static method instance which can have logic to create single instance and is access point for providing the instance to multiple applications. The class has a static data member unique instance to keep the instance information. Okay, let's see how the singleton class will work. Client uses instance method of singleton class to get the instance of this class. The instance method checks for the instance. If instance is already created, then it returns the same, otherwise it creates the instance and returns it to the client. The class has way to create a single instance and to keep it with static variable unique instance. Okay, let's see some modifications and variations applied here. So the access of instance of class is controlled and well defined. It also provides scope to have variable number of instances with small modification. The constructor has to be private so that it can be instantiated directly by client. Here instance uses lazy initialization as instance is created when it is first used. There are other ways too for creating single instance and maybe programming language specific. For example, eager initialization, that is initializing the static variable with creation of instance, so it will be at the time of class loading. It can also be inside a static block or inner class. There can be some other scenarios where multiple instances can be created and has to be taken care appropriately. For example, multi-threaded application has to be taken care for single instance creation. There can be other scenarios too, like serialization, copy constructor, assignment operator, move assignment. Some languages provide reflection facility for creation of instance, so that also has to be taken care. The subclassing requires constructor to be protected and can be supported in multiple ways. One way will be to keep the instances somewhere and provide them when it is required by returning the appropriate one. So where it can be applicable? It can be applicable when one and only one instance of a class is required and well-defined access point is provided to access it by multiple applications.